Hello everyone and welcome back to Veluwe Zoo. In the previous episode we built this habitat for the giant anteaters, but I didn't have the enrichment items that I wanted yet, so I'm gonna check if I already have them. So enrichment items and then the giant anteater. Is it just me or I still don't have it? There's like a giant ant thing that they can eat from or something. Let's check if I already have the research for that. Yeah, see, I've done all the research for the giant anteater and still don't have it. See if I can find it. Oh, well, here it is. Sorry. Natural termite mound. I really wanted these. So let's place this one here and yeah, let's just do a second one. Because it looks so cool. Make sure everything is smooth again. All right, all good. So we have some welfare issues. My animal is thirsty. Why? There is a drink thing here. And the animal is stressed. Just get back in here. See, that always works. So another low welfare. Hydration again. Why isn't he drinking? Because this one is empty. Let's call a keeper to this habitat. My animal died of old age, so call a vet. They also moved a lot of these messages to this timeline thing because I didn't get any messages anymore that animals were fighting or something like that. But you can see it's still happening. But yeah, let's fix this. I'm gonna get to a zoo and animals. Okay, let's move that one to the trade center. Alright, I really hate when the light is like this, so I always do this little trick. And I save it as a blueprint, and then I can just change the time to 12 o'clock, and that looks much better. We have some gifts, so we have adopted and placed 4 different habitat species. Thank you very much for that one. And a yearly donation profit of $107,500. We reached that. We have a low welfare here. You can already see there's really a lot of snakes in here. A lot of puff adders. Puff adder. Select them all. And then send to trade center. See if we still have... Oh, it's empty now. I'll request an animal. And then we put a new puff adder in there. Or an old one. Doesn't really matter. So let's pick this one. It's a male and a female. Oh, you can actually do 2 of them now. Cool. So send to zoo. And we put them in here. We got some mechanic research done. We almost did all the mechanic research, so that's good. So one of my reindeers died, and yeah, he's very lonely now. Let's check. She is very lonely now. So let's give her some company. We're gonna look for some reindeers. People are crazy. They're really crazy. Putting animals up for like 6,000, and I can buy him for $300. What's wrong with them? But at least put another one in here. Might do another female. Oh, there's an animal escaping. What's happening? This is already the second time this is happening. My warthogs were escaping. And now this one. Strange. But where were we? We were buying some new reindeers. Let's get another female in. Now we just have to wait until we get another male for a normal price. Just gonna keep refreshing this one until we see some new animals. Oh, this is taking too long. Let's do something else in the meantime. I did get some messages that, again, people were thinking my entrance prices were too low. So, yeah. They don't have to say that twice to me. Let's increase the price to 45 and 40. Let's see what happens. Ah, look, they're still paying. That's all good. So even more money for me. I'm already a millionaire, but I don't care. Also, I have like 27 exhibit animals over here, so let's sell them all. Another $17,000 for me. I think it's time to sell some flamingos as well. So let's move some of them to the trade center as well. So all these young adults, I'm gonna move them all to the trade center. And send to trade center. Yeah, that's better. So, 2 episodes ago, we started on this desert building, and I really want to finish this one. So yeah, let's switch to the time-lapse right now. And before we can finish the inside, I first remove the roof again, of course, otherwise it's horrible to work indoors. I'm starting a bit different than normally. I already start with a little viewing area right here, and I'm going to add the camels into this building. I think that's one of the few desert animals that are actually in the game, and I thought they would fit in perfectly with this building. But before I start on the actual new habitat, I first want to remove, or maybe basically replace, the barrier that I used for the Gemsbok habitat. I thought the concrete barrier looked a little bit strange, so I'm using the new rope pieces together with the wooden logs to create a new fence. I actually was highly inspired by a picture I saw on Reddit. Someone who did an amazing job with a western styled zoo, and yeah, I saw these that he used these rope pieces together with the wooden logs, and they looked really, really cool. So I thought I might give that one a shot and replace the barrier for the Gemsbok. And I end up basically using them all over the place because it really fits into this area as well. And it really looks cool. It looks much better than just some concrete stuff. So I make sure that also the education stuff is blended perfectly with this new barrier. And I always check again if the animals can't escape and stuff like that. There will be a lot of indoor work today, so I'm gonna do all the plants, all the rocks. It really, really looks cool in the end. I'm really happy with the final result. There will be a little bit more cinematics in the end of the video. I'm gonna show you the entire place, so there will be like 2 or 3 minutes of cinematic shots. I still have to record them, but I already know that that is gonna be a lot, because I just want to show you guys everything that I made in this building. So as I told you, this will be a little viewing area, using the rocks to make sure the animals can't escape here. Again, this habitat won't have any barriers, as we are used to when I'm building a habitat. I'm using this little fence all over the place. This, you can call it a barrier, you can call it a fence, but I'm not using the barriers that are in the game. But yeah, this this habitat will have a few different viewing areas. So you will have this one, you will have the one that is inside the exhibit rock tunnel thing. And on the other side, there is also an entrance to the building, and there will be another viewing area. I think I didn't show you guys this, but I actually moved all the staff buildings to the other side, which is currently outside, but in the end of the video I will also make sure that it is part of the new building. So I'm putting the gate in, and the staff will enter from this side, but you can't really see it in the end. So this is the only thing you will see from the actual barrier. I will cover up the entire wall with these nice desert rocks. I think I will start on that pretty soon. Make sure everything is covered with sand, because the animals probably won't like any grass. And actually, the grass that I'm using here is green, so it doesn't fit the desert theme that we're going for. So this is the second entrance, and this is also the last viewing area we will have for these animals. Again, doing the same thing with the rocks. I really want to cover up everything with rocks and plants, so you really have the idea that when you enter the building, you are entering a desert. And that's also the feeling you get in the building that this one was inspired by. So the Veluwe Zoo in the Netherlands, they also have this wonderful desert indoor area. When you enter it, you really feel like you're entering another world. So it really, really looks cool. And I think I really got the feeling going that I was aiming for in this building as well. So some few rocks. Of course, I would like to make this habitat as interesting as possible, but I can't use much foliage. You will see that later. I have to do my best to make sure everything looks as interesting as possible. So I'm struggling a bit with this one-way glass again. I actually created this shelter space before. I thought that the animals or thought about the animal that was actually going into this habitat, but I think the camels don't really need any shelter space, but it's there anyway, so they can use it. But yeah, it's they probably won't use it as much as I would like to. So I'm fixing the null barriers, and then oh, the camel is already in. I always skip that part for you guys because yeah, then I'm struggling with the animal market, which is, by the way, still not fixed. I already made a ticket for it on the Frontier forums. I really hope they will fix that very soon, because yeah, in the beginning of the video you saw me selling 20, or basically moving 20 flamingos to the trade center, and it took me like 20 minutes to sell them because there was a little bit of lag on the trade center, on the animal market, and that was it's not nice to work with. But yeah, a little bit of foliage, so a few trees, and there were like a really small plants that you can use all over the place, because they don't have a lot of cover for it. And yeah, I basically what I do, and I will skip most of this, I will cover up the entire wall with these rocks, and it's not very interesting for you guys to watch me doing this all over the place, so I will skip it in a few seconds probably. Yeah, right here it is already covered, I think. I'm just making sure that the entrance looks nice, and there's some food and some water for the animals, and then some heaters, just to make sure that the they probably won't, in real life they won't use it because there is a glass roof, and yeah, it's a desert, so it can also get like a minus degrees in the night. But yeah, for this game they probably need some warm temperatures. So I'm creating a nice rock work over here, and again covering everything up nicely, and I'm looking for a nice rock structure that I can use on the other side as well. And then yeah, this is why I skipped most of it, because it's not really interesting to watch me covering up everything. But right now I'm starting on the foliage in this part, and yeah, it really looks cool. It's more like a desert exhibit, or basically a natural exhibit. You will see all the plants and foliage that that is used over there, some cactus trees, and it really, really cool trees, by the way, in the build or in the game. So really nice plants. It's really easy to create something beautiful with these with all these natural things that you can just throw around, and everything looks already much better than it was. So yeah, I will do this all over the place again, a lot of rocks, and yeah, it's basically all the same fences all over the place, because I just really liked the look of it, and yeah, I was just happy with it, so I'm just using them all over this building. I'm struggling a bit with all the curves, and I will change the pathing again later. Yeah, also struggling a bit with the path. Somehow it's not connected to the grid properly, and but you will see that later. I really like these rock structures, so yeah, again I will use this all over the place, and then throw a lot of rocks in there, and then start with the foliage. I really like this. I really like the look of this part of the building when you enter it, and you will go down, and you really have the feeling that you will enter a actual desert. So right now I'm creating a little outdoor terrace, so that people can have a drink and have some food, because I will add some food and drink shops as well to this side. I will probably do that. Yeah, I will do that right now. And here you can see me struggling with the path, and then it wasn't connected to the stairs, and yeah, I don't know what was going on, but it didn't work the way I wanted it. But yeah, I got it fixed in the end, and that's always the thing with the pathing tool. People hate it, but you can really do everything with it. You just have to be patient and just try different things, and yeah, you will get there. So some really simple shops. This is again the theme that is also in the desert building in Veluwe Zoo. They will have a small village like this. I didn't have the space for it anymore. I was planning to add something like that, but I didn't have the room for several shops and like a dining area or something like that. So I chose just to add two simple shops basically, and that's it. But you will have the outdoor area where people can sit down and have a drink. What I did find out is that people don't actually use it, so that's kind of sad, but yeah, it's there, it really looks cool, and I hope in the end some people might use it and enjoy the view on the outdoor area, because that's the part I will do as well in this video. So again, a lot of these fences, I'm trying to make sure everything blends in nicely, and yeah, basically do the same thing all over again. I had some space left over here, so again, some rocks, some nice plants, and make sure everything looks nice. And yeah, I try to skip most of all the rock placement like this, but yeah, it was a lot of rock work in this episode. I know that the rock work in the previous episode wasn't that much, so I wanted to compensate a bit for you guys. I know people who watch my episodes or my series know that I use rocks all over the place, so yeah, I still have to do it, and I have to compensate for whenever I'm not using them as much as I wanted to. So this is the outdoor area, so you will have this little dining space, and yeah, I'm struggling again with the pathing tool over there, making sure everything looks nice, and then I'm starting with the fencing around this little dining area. I will add some picnic tables. I'm going for some other ones that I'm putting down a different one. Then I'm putting down these sunshades, and I thought, yeah, this looks weird, so I have to get some another table, changing the colors a bit. I always like recolorable pieces, so that's always good. Make sure there's some light, so when it's dark, people can still use it. And this little entrance, I'm still not sure what I want to do with that. I just made it really, really simple, but I might change that a little bit off camera when I have a great idea. I will probably change this because there's no door, so any heat can escape from it. Which of course in the game doesn't really matter, but to make it realistic, it does matter. So I might do some little changes over there. I might go for these automatic doors again, as I used in a reptile house. But yeah, I'm not sure. I think in the actual building they will have these plastic things that hang there, and you can go through it. Basically the same thing you will have in like an indoor swimming pool. I'm not sure if they have a name or something like that. I hope you guys get what I mean. But I'm not sure how to make that in the game yet, so I will think about that, and maybe off camera I will change that. But right now I'm starting on the foliage on the outside, so there will be a lot of trees and plants and some nice water thingies, and basically I only cover up this side of the building because I'm not sure yet what I will do on the other side. But for now this area will be finished. So you will have the tropical area, which is as good as finished right now. And I really like those mossy rocks, by the way. You can really create a nice green color inside the water. That's really cool. But yeah, this area for now, it's finished. So I can cover everything up with foliage and the rocks and fences, and make sure everything looks nice. And that's basically what I will do for the rest of the video. And with that, we almost reached the end of it. But make sure you will stick through the cinematics. You will get a nice tour through the building. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. And if you did, make sure you hit the like button. And if you didn't do it already, make sure you subscribe to my channel, so you won't miss out on any new content. And I will speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye!